Please be seated.
Le président, veuillez vous asseoir.
I now hand over to Ieng Sary Defense.
La parole est maintenant
you have 30 minutes for your presentation on the general evidentiary issues raised by the documents relevant to the hearing. You may now proceed.
Vous avez maintenant la parole.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Maître Carnavas.
Good morning, Your Honors.
Bonjour, Monsieur le Président,
and
Madame,
good morning
Messieurs
to everyone in and around the courtroom.
Bonjour à tous ici au présent au prétoire et dans la galerie réservée au public.
Why are we here today?
Pourquoi sommes-nous ici aujourd'hui?
The civil parties would have us believe that we're here today
les parties civiles
because
veulent nous faire croire que nous sommes
is trying
ici aujourd'hui
to delay
parce que la défense essaie de retarder
the defense,
la procédure.
In some sort of a monolithic
que la défense,
group,
comme groupe
is
unique,
obstructing by raising
fait de
objections
en soulevant des exceptions.
We're here today because the prosecution,
nous
as I recall,
ici, si ma mémoire
had
est bonne,
asked prior to the break
l'accusation
for
a
hearing on these matters.
La vacance judiciaire, que l'on
their
tienne
request,
une audience
however,
sur ces questions.
Was not the first request
il
made.
Ne s'agissait pas là, toutefois,
we
de
had
la
made
première
such a request
requête. Nous avions
on at least a half a dozen times
une requête,
prior to the commencement of the trial
avant
proceedings.
Même le début des audiences.
We did so because we knew
et nous
that
l'avons
once
fait,
the documentary evidence was going to be brought into court,
l'épreuve documentaire
that it would be challenged.
Nous savions qu'elle
and
serait
that normally,
contestée.
In these sorts of cases,
et
all
en
those
générale,
challenges, or at least
cas,
most of them,
ces contestations,
prior to trial, not
ont
during
été soulevées
the trial.
Avant le procès,
motions
et pas
are filed.
Le procès.
Dans hearings
général,
are held,
on dépose des requêtes,
decisions
on tient des
are
audiences,
made,
on rend des
and the parties
décisions,
are expected
et les parties doivent respecter ces
with
décisions,
where something may
à
crop up during the presentation of the evidence.
De cas exceptionnels
so
lors
that's
de la
we are here today.
D'éléments de preuve. C'est pourquoi nous sommes
and
ici aujourd'hui.
My learned friends from the civil parties
mes confrères des
that
parties
in a decision on admission of injuries appeal against the OCIJ's constructive denial of Ms. Inksery's request concerning the OCIJ's identification and reliance on evidence obtained
le fait qu'ils aient
through torture.
De preuve,
this was just one of the objections that we had raised.
Voilà, c'était une des
on paragraph
que nous
34,
soulevé,
and this is document
130/7/3/315.
In paragraph 34, the pretrial chamber noted the pretrial chamber further observes that internal rule 87 also gives the charged person the possibility to object to the admissibility of evidence during the trial stage.
Contester la recevabilité d'éléments de preuve lors du procès.
So it is not as if we're trying to obstruct.
Il ne s'agit donc pas là d'obstruction.
It is because lots of issues have not been
mais bien,
resolved.
Parce que plusieurs questions demeurent en
and
suspens.
Let me give you one example before I go into my presentation.
Avant de commencer ma présentation, j'aimerais vous donner cet exemple.
And I raise this example because somehow
j'invoque
the civil parties would have us believe
car les parties civiles
that everything that the co-investigative judges did
que tout ce que les juges d'instruction
is sacrosanct.
Fait
it is without
sacrosanct
it cannot be objected to,
ne saurait faire l'objet
and that it
de
must
contestation
be accepted.
Et doit être réputé comme acceptable.
We had argued, or we had asked the co-investigative judges
nous
to look into documents that were coming from DC camp.
Les documents provenant du centre de documentation du camp.
We raised this objection because, we made this request
cette
for them to look into and to provide us with
d'examiner ces
detailed
documents et de nous fournir
as to how
des renseignements détaillés sur la façon dont
documents
ce centre de documentation avait
by
refait
whom,
la collecte
when,
de ces éléments de preuve.
Where
par
were
qui,
they found,
quand,
how
où
they kept,
avaient-ils été trouvés,
who had access
comment avaient-ils été
to
conservés
them.
Et qui avait accès à
there
ces documents.
A reason for that.
Et pour la bonne
of course,
raison,
as was the fashion with most of the requests
comme,
to the
et,
OCIJ,
comme c'est le cas pour la plupart des requêtes déposées auprès des co-juges
no
d'instruction,
was received.
Nous n'avons
and I invite your honors
réponse.
To look at our third investigative request where we actually ask for the modalities on the investigation itself. So like the Nuncio team, we do take exception to the manner in which the OCIJ carried its investigation and provided the parties with answers to questions sought concerning documentary evidence. Now, before I go into the what we believe are the criteria for the admission of evidence, let me begin by laying out what we believe is the common ground between us and the prosecution,
what we believe we agree.
And I dare say that we're not that far apart on most of the issues.
Nous rejoignons sur la plupart des questions.
I think what we certainly agree in is that this hearing is necessary and that the parties need some certainty.
Et que les parties ont un
and given that certainty,
certitude.
The trial proceedings will be much smoother.
Ce qui viendra améliorer
first, we agree that the ECC rules of admissibility are consistent with international
standards. C'est-à-dire les règles des CETC.
We also agree that Rule 87.3 requires that evidence must meet minimum standards of relevance and reliability.
Les éléments de preuve doivent respecter les normes minimales de pertinence et de fiabilité.
Relevant evidence must have prima facie material to the issues and tend to establish the party's position.
Porter à première vue sur les questions et établir la position des parties.
That Rule 87.3c encompasses the principle of the best evidence rule.
Inclut le principe de la règle du meilleur élément de preuve.
Next, that Rule 87.3 also provides
aussi,
for the exclusion of evidence on the basis
l'exclusion d'éléments de preuve
that it is not allowed under the law.
Le motif qu'il est interdit par la loi.
Also, we agree that statements made under torture fall under the broad category
sous la torture,
of not allowed
la
under the law,
interdit par la loi.
Under Rule 21.3
and
Article 38 of the Cambodian Constitution.
Et l'article 38 de la Constitution du Royaume
and
du
finally,
Cambodge.
We agree that the assessment
que
of weight to be assigned
de la valeur probante
to the evidence is a separate inquiry from admissibility.
Un acte distinct de la recevabilité.
And we also agree, I should say, based on what I heard today, that normally that inquiry is done towards the end.
Pour dire que
once you have all of the evidence
vers la fin, une
and you've heard the testimony, it is only at that point in time,
de tous les
once
de preuve,
you've decided what evidence is relevant,
que la
that you will make the determination in your findings of facts and conclusions of law as to
que la chambre, donc,
what weight to give to the evidence,
le poids
if any. So in other words, the evidence could be relevant,
autrement dit,
but it may have little value in and of itself, even when you assess it with other evidence.
Une fois
but that is something that is left up to you. And incidentally, when I noted that this is the these are the areas where we agree upon
voilà
with the prosecution,
que nous avons avec la
this is based
de
on their response
nous
to our objections on the admissibility of certain categories of documents
quant à la recevabilité de
which
certaines
was filed
catégories
on 16
de
September.
Déposés le 16
it's
septembre,
E-114, paragraphs 7, 8, 8, 9, 9 11,
11,
13,
13
14, 14, and 15.
Et 15.
So I don't think that we're that far apart.
Je crois donc que
I may be somewhat repetitious, but I want to make sure that the record reflects our position, separate and distinct from the position that the prosecution has taken and any other party, lest there be a question down the road that we were less than due diligent in our obligations in defending Mr. Ing Sirri.
Que nous faisons preuve de diligence dans
broadly
le respect
speaking,
ou dans la protection des droits de
we believe there are three major steps in considering the admission
il y a
of
trois
evidence.
À suivre pour considérer la
first,
d'un
the trial
de
chamber
tout
should determine whether the document
doit
is authentic.
Si le document est authentique.
We start, that's our starting point.
Voilà le point de départ,
not relevance, but
pas
whether
la pertinence,
it is authentic.
Bien l'authenticité.
If the OCP were to proffer, for instance, a standing
si
committee
advenant
meetings,
que l'accusation
minutes,
présente
unless and until these minutes are authenticated, they have no value and they should not be used or admitted.
Tant aussi longtemps
so they have to make some sort of showing. And I will speak more specifically with respect to what is required for a document to be deemed authentic.
But authenticity
is very different from reliability. A document can be authentic, but if it has been tampered with,
cela vient différent de la fiabilité. Autrement dit, un document peut être authentique, mais s'il a été altéré, il n'est pas fiable. Par exemple, des éléments de preuve physiques.
You may have the knife
vous pouvez avoir
that actually was the instrument
l'arme blanche qui était l'instrument qui a causé les blessures à une victime.
That's the authentic knife.
Voilà.
But if the
en
knife
effet,
was tampered with,
l'arme blanche authentique,
evidence derived from that knife
cet
may
élément
not
de preuve
necessarily
a été altéré,
be reliable.
Les preuves découlant de cette arme
so
blanche
that's why
ne
you have
peuvent pas être fiables.
The next step.
Voilà pourquoi il faut passer à
you
la
must
prochaine
whether
étape.
The document
il faut déterminer
is reliable.
Si le document est fiable.
And then the third step, of course,
et la troisième étape,
once you've determined that it is authentic
une fois
and reliable,
qu'un élément de preuve a été
then you go to the issue of relevance.
Déterminé comme étant authentique et fiable, il faut aller à sa pertinence.
So those are the three fundamental
voilà donc
steps
les trois
that we
étapes fondamentales
the trial
que,
chamber
nous,
needs to take.
Doivent
once
être suivies
the document,
par la chambre
of course,
de première
is
instance.
In,
une fois les documents
a great deal of
présentés,
how relevant and how much weight to afford this particular document or
et
set
sa
of evidence
probante,
will be determined once you have heard the testimony of the witnesses,
examinés après avoir entendu les témoins,
and you will be in a better position
et la chambre
to make
sera
that
donc en
assessment.
Meilleure position pour procéder à cette évaluation.
And we totally agree with the fact that we are in what I would call
et nous sommes
the
tout à
civil
fait d'accord
law land,
pour dire que nous sommes
as
dans
opposed to
le
the
monde
common law
du
land.
Droit romano-germanique plutôt que celui du common law.
And we do realize that we're dealing with professional judges.
Et que
but that doesn't mean
les juges sont aussi
that some,
des
simply because the prosecution proffers evidence that it automatically
parce que l'accusation
comes in.
And I believe ou présente des éléments de preuve qu'ils doivent
on
être
that
considérés
point.
Comme
if I understood their position
et ils sont d'accord
today,
avec nous, et si j'ai bien compris la position de l'accusation aujourd'hui, elle reconnaît
some effort to show that the
faire un effort pour démontrer
the are
que les documents sont
and
authentiques et fiables.
And of course, relevant
et
to the issue at hand. Because
a
document may be authentic
car un document
and
peut
reliable.
Être authentique et fiable.
It may be fascinating to read,
peut-être même
but it may not be relevant to the issues
mais
at hand.
Peut-être pas
and the whole reason why I believe and we submit that you do need to screen the evidence for to make sure that only relevant evidence comes in
pour vous
is so that you're not left at the end of the trial
pertinent
with
soit là,
all sorts
pour qu'à la fin du procès,
that are not relevant,
vous ne
make
vous retrouviez
pas
avec
for your honors
des éléments de preuve non pertinents qui rendraient votre décision
so
plus
as
difficile.
The trial some screening
et donc
will
au fur et à mesure
needed.
Du déroulement de la procédure,
and of course we firmly believe
devra être fait, nous
in, certain print, in the principle of indubio pereo, so when there is
que le doute profite à l'accusé,
as to the authenticity
dans le doute.
And reliability, as I will speak to in a second, the doubt should go
quant
to the defense.
Quant à l'authenticité ou la fiabilité, ce doute doit profiter à la défense.
Now let me speak briefly about the standard for the admission
laissez-moi
of documents.
Laissez-moi parler tout d'abord des normes quant à la
rule
recevabilité des documents.
Which
en
deals
de
with
la règle
the appearance of witnesses and experts and Rule 87 of the Rules of Evidence together
ou plutôt, la règle
govern
83, quant,
the admissibility
les témoins, les
of testimony, of testimonial evidence.
Règle 87
other
sur les règles de preuve.
Documentary evidence is admissible subject to the requirements of Rule 87.3.
D'autres éléments de preuve
and
documentaires
as you will know, Your Honors,
sont recevables dans le respect des exigences
the chamber
de la règle 87.3.
Evidence where it finds,
la
as
chambre
the prosecution
peut rejeter
noted,
une demande
is irrelevant or repetitious.
Déclarer ce
impossible
de preuve s'il s'avère dénué de pertinence
to,
ou il a un caractère
to be obtained within a reasonable time,
s'il est impossible à obtenir dans un
unsuitable to prove the facts it
s'il est insusceptible
to prove,
de prouver ce qu'il entend
not allowed under the law,
s'il est interdit par la loi
or that it's intended to prolong
ou s'il est destiné à prolonger
the proceedings or is frivolous
ou s'il est autrement abusif.
Rule 87.1 states that and I quote unless provided otherwise in the rule and
cite,
these internal rules, all evidence
la
is admissible.
En matière pénale est libre.
All evidence is admissible unless
est
provided
libre,
otherwise in the internal
sauf
rules.
Disposition contraire.
This incorporates,
ce
we submit, and I believe, as our colleagues acknowledged.
Et nous considérons,
this incorporates
donc,
the civil law principles of the free evaluation of the evidence into the ECC internal rules under which the court evaluates the evidence according to the free conviction obtained from the entire trial, subject to the understanding, as I noted, that in case of doubt,
conviction obtenue
the evidence should be evaluated in the light most favorable
et que
to
cela
the accused.
Doit être,
so again, as you can see, we agree
que dans
on many
cas de doute,
facets
les éléments de preuve devraient être évalués
on the admissibility of evidence.
À la faveur de l'accusé.
At the ECCC, the principle
CETC,
of the free evaluation of evidence is, however,
preuve,
subject to the qualifications enumerated in Rule 87.3,
toutefois respecter les critères de la règle 87.3,
which confer discretion on the trial chamber to reject
à la
a request for evidence where it finds
la liberté de rejeter
that it is
un élément
irrelevant
de preuve, s'il
or
repetitious, dénué de pertinence ou
impossible to be obtained within a reasonable time,
dans un délai raisonnable,
to prove the facts
s'il est insusceptible
to prove,
de prouver ce qu'il entend établir,
not allowed
s'il
under
est interdit
the law,
par la loi,
or where it's intended to prolong the proceeding. So there are,
ou quand il est destiné à prolonger la procédure.
Some qualifications.
Donc il existe
now, in
des conditions.
Case 001, in your judgment, and I'm referring
dans
to in particular
jugement,
paragraph 41,
dans le dossier 1, paragraphe 41,
you consider these qualifications as held, and I quote,
la chambre
to be used
instance,
as evidence,
que
material
c'est
of the case file must satisfy certain
donc,
conditions
pour être utilisé
of
comme
relevance
preuve, un élément tiré
and probative
du dossier
value.
Doit remplir certains critères de pertinence et de valeur probante.
The chamber may reject
la Chambre
any
peut ainsi déclarer irrecevable tout élément produit devant elle sur la base des critères mentionnés à la règle 87.3 du règlement intérieur, puis vous en donnez la liste.
So I'm not saying anything that you, Your Honors, have not already concluded.
C'est une conclusion que vous avez
on
déjà
another occasion, on case 001, in this case,
un autre moment, dans
you
le
held
dossier 1,
that the effect of
la
Rule
87.3 statué
was
que
that,
l'effet
quote,
de la règle
87.3
était, je cite,
as evidence, material on the case file must
être utilisé
satisfy
comme preuve,
minimum
les documents
standards
dans le
of relevance
dossier pénal
and
doit respecter les normes minimales de pertinence et de fiabilité nécessaires pour sa production devant la Chambre.
Once produced before the chamber,
et donc une fois,
the probative value of the evidence, and hence the weight
produit devant la chambre,
to be accorded
la valeur
to it
probante de
will
cette
be then assessed.
Et son poids
and this was
évalués.
In your decision on the admissibility
c'était
of evidence,
votre décision sur la recevabilité des preuves en date
May 2009,
du 26 mai 2009,
seven,
paragraphe 7,
and the document is
et le document à côté est le E43-4.
When determining whether to admit film material
s'il convient d'admettre
in case 001,
films,
Your Honors,
dans le document, dans le dossier 1,
held that admissible,
la Chambre a
that the material was admissible subject to review of its relevance and authenticity
d'un examen
during
de sa pertinence
the substantive
et de son authenticité
hearing.
Lors de l'audience
and this
fond.
Is in E/5/10/2. Para 16.4 on your decision on admissibility of new materials
16.4
and directions to the parties 10
March 2009.
And you will note, Your Honors, if you go through the jurisprudence,
je vous renvoie à la jurisprudence.
Sometimes you have relevance and then authenticity,
parfois on
but
examine
the concepts are there as
la
we will,
pertinence,
and we maintain that when you look at,
selon nous,
the rules,
lorsqu'on se penche sur les
and you look at your own
jurisprudence
that you have from,
votre propre
jurisprudence from case 001, your own decisions,
un,
it becomes clear to us
il apparaît clairement
that
pour nous
for evidence to be admissible,
que
the document must meet the minimum threshold of authenticity,
elle doit atteindre
reliability,
d'authenticité,
and relevance.
Et pertinence.
And as I've noted,
et comme je l'ai
that
dit,
the principle of in dubio pro reo
le principe selon
is
quoi le profit à l'accusé
so when determining whether each of these criteria have been fulfilled,
si chacun de ces critères a
we
été
must
rempli,
highlight
il
that the principle
toujours
of in dubio pro reo
appliquer
applies.
Le principe
this principle
selon quoi
requires
le doute profite à l'accusé,
the chamber to resolve
en vertu de quoi
any uncertainties
la chambre doit trancher toute incertitude
of the accused.
En faveur
and in fact,
de
the Supreme Court
d'ailleurs,
chamber,
la Chambre
in decision,
de la Cour suprême a rendu
an
une décision
appeal,
sur l'appel immédiat
in the Doig case, in,
interjeté
by Q. Sampan,
par Q. Sampan
an application for release, that's 6 June
contre la décision de l'instance à demande de remise en liberté. C'est le document E50/3/1/4, paragraphe 31, décision 2011. Je cite, la Chambre de la Cour suprême se doit de souligner que ce principe
déclarant by the Constitution of Cambodia,
and
has as its primary function,
as its primary function,
to denote a default finding in the event where factual doubts are not removed by the evidence. And of course, we have cited in the past, and we're happy to cite again, ICTY jurisprudence
du TPIY, nous allons le faire à nouveau, c'est l'affaire de la Leach et l'affaire Limay. Ici, le principe selon quoi le doute profite à l'accusé a été appliqué. Dans le contexte international, il faut préciser que dans ces affaires en question, ce n'était pas lié aux faits, pour qu'on ne puisse pas me reprocher de mal avoir cité les sources de la jurisprudence.
A little bit of the specifics, and I apologize again if I am being somewhat repetitive
from
the arguments that you heard earlier today.
Certains déjà
but let me discuss a little bit more specifically the requirements of authenticity, reliability,
de fiabilité
and relevance.
Et de pertinence.
Authenticity.
D'abord, l'authenticité.
It must be determined,
l'authenticité doit être
prior
établi
to the admission of evidence.
L'admission de l'élément de
and
preuve,
the
selon nous,
must at least
et
make a prima facie showing
que les parties montrent
of authenticity in order
qu'à première
for documents
vue,
to
le
be admissible under
pour
Rule
que celui-ci soit recevable en application de la règle
87.3c.
Selon
no
nous,
such showing
à ce
has
jour,
actually been made.
Cela n'a pas été
we also
montré.
Submit that pointing to the OCIJ and saying, well, they assessed the evidence,
dit que les
this was all done at that stage, don't worry,
et que cela
be
a
happy,
été fait. Lorsqu'on
just
dit,
accept
ne vous inquiétez pas,
and rely
acceptez
upon it,
cela,
is not sufficient,
d'instruction.
And it certainly
nous disons
is not
pas suffisant,
consistent
nous disons que ceci
the law that you must apply
conforme aux normes
before
de droit que vous vous devez
this particular tribunal.
Devant les CETC.
We submit that an inauthentic
nous,
document is unsuitable to prove the facts it purports to prove, and that it should be ruled inadmissible pursuant to 87.3c. Now, in case 001, the trial chamber excluded the statements of two deceased witnesses tendered by the OCP.
Déclaration qui était présentée par les
and you stated, the trial chamber stated,
a dit,
the chamber excludes these statements due to their origin,
content, leur contenu,
their contested character,
litigieux,
and the inability of the accused to challenge their veracity.
De contester
these factors render these statements unsuitable to prove the facts they purport to prove in accordance with Rule 87C.
En application de la règle 87C.
And this is your decision on the admissibility of material in the case file.
Sur la recevabilité.
Paragraph 16,
paragraph
of
16
E
c'est le document
43/4. We can also look at jurisprudence from the ICTY and the ICTR. There, the rule
devant
is, I believe, 89E.
C'est, je pense, la règle
89E
qui est pertinente. Cette règle indique que la Chambre peut demander la vérification de l'authenticité des éléments de preuve obtenus hors du tribunal. Bien sûr, la règle dit que la Chambre peut le faire.
Per se,
ce n'est pas une règle en soi, mais d'après nous, la partie qui entend présenter un document dans le cadre de la démonstration de la fiabilité de celui-ci doit donner
as to what
certaines
the
indications
document is
quant à la nature du
and
document
and that it is genuine
quant à son authenticité avant que le document en question ne puisse être admis en tant qu'élément de preuve.
And if you can look at, Your Honors,
je
the Bogosora case at ICTR
à l'affaire
Bogosora
du TPIR, affaire
on admission
41T,
of certain evidence in September 13, 2004, paragraph 8. There's also a Popovich decision from the ICTY concerning this matter, decision on admissibility of intercepted communications, September 2007, paragraph 35. I should note, Your Honors, also for the record that much of the authority cited here today has been cited in our numerous submissions over the course of the last few years. Material which lacks authenticity must, by its very nature,
par définition même,
lack probative
n'ont
value.
Pas de valeur probante.
So you don't even get the probative value if you can't get past that hurdle of authenticity.
Remplir le critère d'authenticité, on doit même pas examiner la valeur probante.
Prosecution is correct in saying that the hurdle
de dire
that they have to overcome
que l'obstacle qu'elle doit surmonter pour établir l'authenticité d'un document pourrait être relativement bas. Il ne faut pas aller jusqu'à une certitude au-delà du doute raisonnable. Mais
to be thinking about the way to be given to this document unless you are satisfied, unless you are satisfied
que l'on
that the document
établi
is authentic, and I dare say
que le document est authentique,
reliable,
et comme je l'ai dit,
as well.
Ce document est également fiable.
The ICTR Musena trial
dans
chamber stated,
Moussema,
when assessing the authenticity of documentary evidence,
a évalué l'authenticité des preuves documentaires, qu'elle avait pris en considération leur forme, leur contenu,
the purported use of the document, as well as whether the document is an original
or copy.
If it is a copy,
si c'est
whether
une copie,
it is registered
savoir,
or filed
si
with an
été
institutional authority,
déposé ou enregistré auprès d'une autorité
whether it is signed,
institutionnelle,
sealed,
le point
stamped,
savoir s'il est signé,
or certified
scellé,
in any other way,
ou certifié,
and whether
et le point de
it was
savoir
duly executed,
that is, written, exécuté, c'est-à-dire
or
rédigé,
authorized
produit, ou autorisé
by the person
par
or party
la personne ou la partie
purporting to be its author.
Se présente comme son auteur.
This is the ICTR
c'est
Musema case,
Musema,
judgment and sentence,
UTPIR, 96-13-T,
judgment and sentence, 27 January 2000, in paras 66. And
67.
So when we look at the ICTR and ICTY jurisprudence,
si l'on examine la jurisprudence,
they are not far apart from the expectations that are required before this particular tribunal when it comes
ce n'est pas
to the admission
de ce
of documentary evidence
concernant l'admissibilité des preuves documentaires.
A document's reliability.
La fiabilité d'un document.
And now I'm switching to reliability.
À présent, j'en viens à la question
must be determined prior to the
doit
admission of evidence as well.
Avant l'admission de l'élément
an unreliable document,
un document qui n'est pas fiable
would be unsuitable to prove the facts
de prouver ce qu'il entend établir
it may be ruled
et pourra donc être déclaré irrecevable
under rule
selon nous en application de la règle 87.3.
And we direct your attention
nous attirons
to
votre
Doic
sur
decision on admissibility
rendue
of material
dans
on the case file.
Duc.
Dated 26 May 2009, E43/4, paragraph 7 and 16.
En date du 26
now, we acknowledge that almost any aspect of form,
pratiquement tous les aspects
content,
de la forme, du contenu,
or origin
ou de l'origine de l'information,
information can be an addition of reliability. And I want to take the time to commend the co-prosecutor for listing the indicia. I thought that was an excellent presentation and very
très
comprehensive
instructif, très
and
complet.
A guide to
je
all of us.
Les en remercie.
So, and I point that out because I
je
do
tenais
agree,
à le dire parce
we agree
que nous convenons, nous aussi,
that you have to look at
qu'il convient
some indicia
d'examiner
of reliability.
Certains indices de fiabilité.
There is no finite list.
Il n'existe pas de liste exhaustive
criteria,
de critères possibles.
Or automatic reasons,
il n'existe
however,
pas non plus
to either admit or exclude a piece of evidence.
D'admettre ou
that's
d'exclure automatiquement un élément de preuve.
As the prosecution was suggesting.
C'est la raison pour laquelle, comme
and
l'a dit l'accusation,
one of the reasons we were asking for hearings, Your Honor, was
et si nous avons demandé
we
des audiences sur les documents,
we
c'est parce que nous voulons procéder à un
instance, lay out the
nous voulons que l'accusation
not simply to say, well, I, this document
examine ces documents sans se contenter de nous dire ce document vient du DCCAM. Et donc, c'est un avis de fiabilité. Pour nous, ce n'est pas le cas. C'est tout au plus le contraire. Soyons francs, le CDCAM n'est pas objectif. Le DCCAM est un organe militant.
Indicated
le DCCAM
clearly
a
how it has received the documents, what sort of criteria it has used, how it's been obtained,
dont les documents
and certainly when it comes to any statements that they may have taken, keeping in mind that they are a party
DCCAM,
of interest,
une
and because
qui est
of their inherent prejudice towards the accused,
qui
that anything that has DCCAM on it must be
tout
suspect
ce qui vient
to begin
du DCCAM
with.
Doit être
it doesn't necessarily mean
suspect
that it's not authentic or
ça ne veut pas dire que ce n'est pas authentique ou fiable,
something,
mais
some
cela
of
veut dire que certains indices d'authenticité et de fiabilité doivent être présentés de la part de qui que ce soit, de la part de la partie qui prétend faire admettre l'élément de preuve en question.
Factors that have been taken into
les facteurs qui ont été pris en
considération
devant les tribunaux spéciaux
do include the appearance of documents, including any signature stamps,
l'apparence des documents, y
fax stamps,
des signatures,
sequential number designations, or any other
de fax,
markings.
Des
and there's lots of jurisprudence on that. I won't go on because, as I
et
noted,
il y a beaucoup
we agree
là-dessus.
In principle with the prosecution.
Parce que sur le principe, nous sommes d'accord avec l'accusation.
Before a document is deemed
avant
admissible, there must be sufficient indicia.
Il doit présenter des indices suffisants
that make it, that make a prima facie case for its admission. And I think here's again what we agree with.
Pour qu'il puisse être considéré
à première vue
comme étant recevable.
But it's the Dlalić case.
Je vais citer la décision
in the ICTY
rendue au TPIY.
A rule that
cette décision a établi la règle en question.
Has gone unchallenged.
C'est une règle qui n'a pas été contestée.
And it's fixed.
Et qui
and you may look at the decision on the application
établi
of Dlalić for leave to appeal against the decision of the trial
sur la demande d'autorisation présentée par Dlalić en vue
of 16
de
January
1998. La chambre de première instance le 10 janvier 1998. C'est le paragraphe 20
connected
de la
to a document's reliability, of course, is
à la fiabilité d'un document et sa valeur probante.
And according to the
jurisprudence
of the ad hoc tribunal,
des tribunaux spéciaux,
a document must meet some threshold
atteindre
of reliability
un seuil de
to be considered
pour être considéré comme
like
ayant valeur probante. Comme
a
c'est le cas pour l'authenticité, un document
some threshold
doit atteindre un certain seuil de fiabilité
to be considered probative.
Pour être considéré comme ayant valeur probante.
Haji Hasanovic
dans
Kubra
l'affaire Haji Hasanovic
at
the ICTY, dont a eu à connaître le TPIY,
they know
la chambre,
the trial chamber noted that
de première instance,
must have,
a relevé
quote,
que le document devait présenter une certaine pertinence et une certaine
this
valeur probante. Cela veut dire que pour être déclaré recevable, la chambre ne doit pas déterminer la valeur probante précise du document en question dans la mesure où ce sera fait ultérieurement.
We're not suggesting that you need to resolve this issue.
Que la question doit être réglée.
But the probative value
mais la valeur
itself
probante,
is a quality of necessary, which is necessarily, it varies depending on the circumstances and the facts.
En fonction des circonstances et des faits de l'espèce.
Connected to all of this, of course,
il y a un aspect qui est lié à tout
the best evidence rule.
C'est
and it was mentioned briefly by one of our colleagues.
Qui a été mentionné brièvement par
I don't
l'un
recall
de nos
right now whether the prosecution touched upon
je
it.
Ne sais pas si
but the best evidence rule
mais la règle de la
generally requires primary evidence
exige en général
for the purpose of proving the content of the document.
Preuve primaire soit présentée
words,
pour établir le contenu d'un document.
The original, why would you not want to use
si
the original?
L'on dispose de l'original, pourquoi
keeping
ne l'utiliserait-on
mind,
pas
however, that we are in this international setting where
nous sommes dans un contexte
international, not in a domestic setting where you may have 5 or 10 or maybe 100 documents. Here we're dealing with
10 ou 100 documents.
Of thousands
ici,
of documents,
il s'agit de centaines de milliers de documents.
In many instances,
du coup,
very difficult
à bien
to
égards,
use the original documents.
Les documents originaux
and
dans bien
therefore,
des cas.
You must
et donc,
look at the best evidence rule and apply it with some flexibility.
La règle de la meilleure preuve et l'appliquer
and
avec
we recognize
une certaine souplesse.
That and we
nous en
urge
sommes
you to take
conscients.
That approach.
Nous pensons qu'il convient d'adopter cette démarche.
But the best evidence rule
mais
is
cette règle
a guiding evidentiary principle
est un principe
also that has been used before the ad hoc
utilisé
tribunals.
Également devant les tribunaux spéciaux.
And I Just as an example, you may look at the Perisic case, IT-0481, order for guidelines on the admission and presentation of evidence and conduct of counsel in court. That's 29 October 2008, paragraph 36.
En date du 29 octobre 2008, paragraphe 36.
Now, the underlying assumption of the best evidence rule is that secondary evidence
of
a document's content is not as reliable as a document itself. And I think we had that interplay last week where Mr. Mungia is saying, well, show me the original. How do I know that this is reliable
or even authentic? Que c'est fiable, voire authentique.
This rule comes into play in cases in which there is a reason to suspect that the original or one of several counterparts' originals is different in some material way from other counterparts or copies or from the recollection of witnesses. So in other words, if there is a reason to suspect. Now, let me just pause here for a second. Since we've never had a hearing of any sort where the prosecution
il n'y a jamais eu d'audience où could show the indicia of reliability, not indicia of the documents, de fiabilité, d'authenticité
where
des documents,
a party
et
raises
une
an issue,
partie aurait soulevé une
there's
question,
a reason to suspect that the original is not sufficient.
Il y aurait eu des raisons de penser que, et que, qu'on aurait eu des raisons
course,
de penser que l'original n'était pas suffisant.
We believe that now that we're having this hearing,
à présent que nous avons cette audience,
the prosecution will provide what it believes are the indicia of authenticity and reliability, and upon doing so, those documents would be able to be used, the copies that is. But where there is reason, then, and where the originals exist, that's when we believe the best evidence rule does in fact kick in.
Nous pensons que la règle de meilleure preuve intervient.
Because there may be a suggestion that there was a forgery
car
ex post facto.
Il se peut que les documents aient été
that the document itself was tampered with, in other words.
A posteriori,
that it's a montage. And it's not something that is unheard of.
Et cela ne serait pas inédit.
We believe the best evidence rule,
selon nous, la règle de la meilleure preuve,
does play a role before this tribunal.
Un rôle devant les CETC.
The trial chamber may also request
la chambre
for evidence
pourrait également
to be rejected where
rejeter
it's more prejudicial, the effect of it would be more prejudicial than probative.
Leur effet
more prejudiciable than probative.
Sur
now I understand that earlier I indicated
probante.
That first you have to let
it
admit if it's authentic, reliable,
la fiabilité,
you get to the probative, the weighing of it at some other point.
Probante,
but some evidence
mais
may on its face be so prejudicial and have so little value that it may
vue,
be evidence
si
that at some point
si
you may be required to make a determination at that point. Even though
que la
we do realize that we are dealing with professional judges who are not expected to be swayed by passion or prejudice and that are perfectly capable
of
setting aside anything that may be more prejudicial than probative.
De déterminer quels éléments
at the IC, at the ad hoc tribunals, a document is insufficiently reliable when its prejudicial effect on the fairness of the proceedings outweighs its probative value. And you can find a good example
Jean
in the Kvatska case,
pour exemple, l'affaire Kvatska,
where the trial chamber decided to exclude
la chambre de première instance
in the interest
a décidé
of a fair trial
dans l'intérêt d'un procès équitable,
an extract of a new,
un extrait
from a newspaper
d'un article de journal
from the Omarska camp,
sur le camp de Omarska,
as its probative value was low
sa valeur
in that it contained unsupported allegations regarding the camp
non étayées concernant
the
le
inflammatory
camp,
nature of these allegations was so prejudicial to the defense that this outweighed any probative value it may have.
Que sur toute and
this
valeur
is prosecution versus
Kvatska. Kvatska.
Decision on exhibit
décision sur les pièces à conviction,
19
July 2001, page 2.
Now, this is a good example in our case because
c'est un bon exemple,
there are many instances where the prosecution
en effet, dans bien des cas,
or the civil parties
l'accusation, ou
may wish to rely
civils,
on newspaper articles.
S'appuyer sur des articles de presse.
And what may be contained in those articles
et le contenu de cet
may
article
be prejudicial but not necessarily
être
probative,
préjudiciable, mais ne
especially
pas
when
avoir
you
de
consider that the whatever is being cited inside of the document
tout ce qui est
itself
cité dans les documents
cannot
même
be challenged.
Ne peut être
in other words,
contesté.
There would also be
autrement dit,
a problem with the right of confrontation.
Qu'il y aurait un problème du point de vue du droit à être confronté.
So at the ICTY, this principle
au
that
TPY,
a document may be rejected
selon lequel
when its prejudicial
peut être
effect outweighs the probative value
sur sa
is expressly codified
ce principe
in
est
rule
expressément
89D.
Codifié dans la règle
now,
89D.
At the ICTR,
cela n'est pas le cas devant
the
le TPIR,
or the Special Court for Sierra Leone.
Ni à la
However,
au
they have,
pour la Sierra Leone.
Nonetheless,
mais
applied
ces tribunaux
this broad
ont néanmoins
the broad discretion to exclude evidence
fait usage de leur
when the trial chambers believed that it was more prejudicial than probative. And you can see that in the, for instance,
que la valeur probante était inférieure.
The Calamera case, decision on the prosecution motion for admission
je vous
into evidence
à
of post-arrest interviews
la décision sur la requête de la défense enfin l'admission en tant qu'élément de preuve
Giro Rera
d'entretien
and
avec Joseph Nigirorera et Mathieu Nguirompassé effectué après leur arrestation
November
document
2007
de paragraph 3, 3.
And in the Norman case,
je vous cite également
of the Special Court
Norman,
of Sierra Leone,
tribunal
this is a decision on the prosecution's request
une décision
to
sur une demande
to admit evidence
visant à faire admettre
into evidence
de
certain
preuve, certains
documents pertaining to Rule
92
bis
and 89C,
14 July 2005. So if we can see that this principle
comme on le voit,
is a principle that is widely used at the international tribunals,
devant les tribunaux internationaux.
While we maintain that the trial chamber
nous,
here must first and foremost always apply Cambodian law and the Cambodian
le droit cambodgien.
Rules of procedure and your internal rules, that's your starting point, because those are grounded
et le règlement intérieur, ça c'est le
within
point de part,
the context and the framework of this particular institution, which is also grounded within the framework of the Cambodian constitution, you can, for guidance, look to these other
on peut certes s'inspirer de ce qui se fait devant les autres tribunaux,
they are more hybrid,
et le cas échéant, il faut se souvenir de nature hybride des tribunaux en question par opposition au système romano-germanique qui prévaut ici.
Lastly, I want to talk about the
je voudrais enfin
inadmissibility of statements made
en venir
pursuant
à l'irrecevabilité des déclarations dont les auteurs ont été l'objet d'incitations.
Rule 21.3 states no form of inducement,
coercition ou
physical
de coercion.
Coercion or threats thereof, whether directed
selon
against the interviewee or others, may be used in any interview. If such inducements, coercions or threats are used, the statements recorded shall not be admissible as evidence before the court. And of course, in case 001,
dans l'affaire 001,
both the pretrial chamber and the trial chamber,
préliminaire et la chambre
and
première instance,
the trial chamber, I should say, in 001, but in 002,
première instance,
this case,
mais dans
the pretrial chamber
2,
and trial
les
chamber
deux chambres
have found that pursuant to Rule
21.3,
quote, the facts that a confession has been made
and
that it has
fait,
was made under torture is,
not,
torture is an admissible fact. However, the contents of the confession made under torture cannot
fait,
be acceptable, accepted as a truthful statement.
Fait sous la torture
we,
ne peut être
we will go into the specifics of the sort of documents that we believe are not acceptable. But lastly, because
le
I see my time is running out, let me talk a little bit about relevance, just 30 seconds.
Il me reste peu de temps.
A document's relevance must be determined prior to
la
the admission
doit
of evidence,
avant
as I've indicated
que le document soit admis en tant qu'élément
earlier,
de preuve, comme
to avoid the admission
dit,
of countless of documents which cannot be shown to have any to be relevant or linked
pertinence ne peut
to any relevant
être
issues.
Établie. ni leur lien avec une question pertinente. Bien sûr, c'est la partie qui propose un document qui doit expliquer sa pertinence.
And how so?
En
relevance has been defined as evidence that tends to prove or disprove a material issue. In other words, evidence is relevant if its effect is to make more or less probable the existence of a fact.
La pertinence, ou plutôt,
which is an issue.
Un élément de preuve est pertinent si son effet est de rendre plus ou moins probable l'existence d'un fait en question.
Having determined that a document is authentic,
une fois qu'on a établi l'authenticité et la fiabilité d'un document,
rather than just admitting
plutôt
it wholesale,
que de l'admettre,
you take that other extra step to determine why
il faut aller plus loin
the evidence, the documentary evidence, is also relevant. And how so?
La preuve documentaire est également pertinente, et de quelle manière?
If a party
tout comme
were to
on le ferait si une partie interrogeait un témoin,
and they're going off on a tangent.
En
it might be
s'écartant du sujet.
It might be prejudicial
c'est
to
peut-être intéressant.
The being
c'est peut-être préjudiciable pour la personne
it might
interrogée. Ça peut être aussi fascinant à écouter.
Relevant,
mais si cela n'est pas pertinent, la Chambre devrait intervenir, couper la partie qui pose la question,
minimum,
ou tout au moins, elle devrait demander à la partie d'expliquer pourquoi cette ligne d'interrogatoire est pertinente.
What charge,
par rapport à quelle partie de l'acte d'accusation,
quelle paragraph
charge,
in the
quel paragraphe
order
de l'ordonnance de clôture.
So just as you would expect the parties
tout comme
to do nothing, to ask nothing but relevant questions,
les parties
we submit,
ne doivent poser que des questions pertinentes, nous pensons
even at the admissibility stage,
que même à la phase d'examen de la recevabilité, il ne faut pas accepter de
relevant
documents qui ne sont
that, Your
pas
Honors,
pertinent.
I and again, I
là-dessus,
to thank the trial
Mesdames, Messieurs les juges, j'en ai terminé. Je remercie la Chambre de m'avoir permis de présenter nos observations à
thank
ce
you
sujet. Merci.
President,
le
thank
président.
You, Defense Counsel.
Je vous remercie.
Being sorry. I now hand over to Kyiv Sampon's
la
defense.
Parole est maintenant à l'équipe de défense de Kyiv Sampon.
You have 30 minutes for your presentation on the general evidentiary issues raised by the documents relevant to this hearing.
La recevabilité des documents.
You may now proceed.
Et vous avez maintenant la parole.
Defense Counsel. Thank you, Mr. President.
Maître,
good morning, Your Honours. Good morning, everyone.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président. Bonjour, Madame, Messieurs les juges. Bonjour à tous.
For today's hearing, I'd like to make some brief remarks.
J'aimerais
as
vous présenter mes observations générales.
Colleagues already indicated relevant points regarding the documents.
Mes confrères ont déjà soulevé plusieurs points.
The statement made by the prosecutor,
j'ai aussi entendu les arguments présentés par l'accusation.
Many points, so that it is
nous sommes d'accord
the discretion
avec
of
plusieurs
the
de ces points, c'est-à-dire que c'est à la Chambre de trancher.
First of all, I'd like to draw your Honor's attention to rule 87,
j'aimerais d'abord rappeler
point one,
la règle 87.1
regarding rules of evidence.
La règle 87, je le rappelle, traite des règles de preuve.
That is the main focus of our hearing today.
Ce qui est d'ailleurs l'objet
des audiences
d'aujourd'hui.
I believe there is a misunderstanding regarding the content of this rule.
Il semblerait y avoir
the rule of
mauvaise compréhension de la teneur de cette règle.
Before the chamber,
il s'agit d'une
the
règle applicable
misunderstanding is that
au tribunal, mais la
the word admissible
and I like to terme
put a, an
recevable
entire for rule 87.1 which
j'aimerais
is
lire
unless provided otherwise
donc
in these internal rules all the evidence is admissible. The word admissible is used in the English language.
Libre. En anglais, on utilise
that
le terme admissible.
The chamber shall accept,
autrement dit, la Chambre,
the document submitted by the parties,
accepte les documents présentés par les parties.
However, it means, although the Chamber accepts those documents submitted by the parties, it doesn't mean the documents are all admissible.
Ça ne signifie pas que tous les documents sont jugés recevables.
That is, the Chamber shall accept the document for debate.
C'est-à-dire que ce document est accepté
and
au fin du débat.
Distinction.
Et voilà
which
donc
links
la différence.
To below sub-rules.
Qui,
so I think there is a misunderstanding of the word
de la règle. Donc,
admissible in Rule 87.1.
En anglais,
in order for documents to be admissible, it has to be first accepted and
avant
then
d'être
debated
jugé recevable, un document doit être
by
accepté et doit faire l'objet de débat par les parties.
In order to verify if the evidence is appropriate or otherwise, if the document is admitted without a debate,
si un document
how could
est
a judge know for sure the weight or the probative value
comment
of such
les juges
a document?
Peuvent-ils déterminer la valeur probante du dit document?
For that reason, it requires a debate, a discussion
c'est
from all the concerned parties
un débat oral
to find whether
toutes les parties
it
concernées
is relevant. And I believe
pour juger
the point
de la pertinence
has been raised by
de
l'élément
de preuve. Je pense que ce point avait été soulevé par les coprocureurs.
That the document shall be credible
le document doit être
debate,
jugé
and this is a core distinction
crédible
in this rule,
par
and
un débat.
For
et voilà
the
la distinction
decision
donc,
of the chamber.
Pour cette règle.
The issue of
what type of evidence shall be admissible and considered
la question du type d'éléments de preuve
in
jugé
regards
recevable.
To its probative value. Of course, it is at the discretion of the chamber on its credibility.
Il est, relève du pouvoir d'appréciation de la chambre
relevance.
De déterminer la crédibilité.
And I repeat, it is at the discretion of the chamber. However, it also means the chamber can just not accept any document.
Cela signifie aussi que la chambre ne peut pas accepter
journals,
n'importe quel document.
Journals, of course, adhere to the principle of credibility or relevance
la
of those documents
est liée au principe
before
de
you decide to admit them.
Pertinence de ces documents
as
avant
whether
de
they
les
are inculpatory or exculpatory.
Recevoir, recevable, à savoir les éléments de preuve à charge et à décharge.
Another point that we shall consider is that why there shall be a debate on the evidence.
Pourquoi doit-il y avoir un pourquoi ces éléments de preuve plutôt doivent-ils être débattus?
I believe the chamber as well as the co-procureurs are aware of the onus of presenting the evidence on the co-procureur.
Est bien consciente qu'il revient à l'accusation la responsabilité de présenter
so
les preuves à charge.
So, in order for the evidence to be presented before the chamber, what are the standards
donc,
or the rules that we need to adhere to?
Les normes
especially
ou les règles
for
que nous devons respecter dans le dépôt
them.
De l'élément de preuve à l'audience,
we
notamment pour l'accusation.
That is a document. So
un principe veut
the probative value of the document
la valeur probante
d'un reasonable
document
doubt, as also stated by defense counsel Michael Canavas.
Hors de tout doute raisonnable, tel que rappelé par
so
Maître Canavas.
The best rule of evidence is
la règle
a norm
de la meilleure
to be adhered to and applied by the co-prosecutors.
Que les co-procureurs doivent respecter.
And if the co-prosecutors fails to carry out this task, that is to apply the best
et si
rules of evidence,
l'accusation ne respecte pas ce principe de la règle de la meilleure preuve,
it means if there is any doubt, the doubt shall benefit the accused.
S'il subsiste un doute, celui-ci
it
doit profiter à l'accusé.
The chamber shall favor the accused if there is any doubt in the document presented by the prosecution.
La chambre doit trancher en faveur de l'accusé si tout doute subsiste quant enfin aussi un doute
plane sur le document. So it requires that the prosecution presents the proof beyond reasonable doubt.
L'accusation doit donc
so if in this present context, if we refer to Rule 87.1,
dans le contexte actuel, si l'on porte notre attention à la règle 87.1,
opine that and all evidence is admissible, then there is no need to have this oral argument at all.
Eh bien, il n'y a pas lieu d'avoir le débat d'aujourd'hui.
The oral argument, we have no way in order to find out or establish the reliability of
la fiabilité
the evidence
d'un élément de preuve.
Responding
to what the representative of the civil party,
pour répondre aux avocats des parties civiles,
which argues that the argument by the defense is meant to prolong the proceeding. I think this is seriously misleading.
Affirmé que les objections de la défense avaient une
because of course the hearing of the case of this magnitude must involve examinations of thousands of documents
comme celle qui nous occupe signifie un dossier pénal
and I'm sure that it requires a lot of times to debate on that and it is not a waste of time. So
il
how
faut
do we
beaucoup
do
de
it?
Temps pour débattre de ces documents. Ce n'est pas une perte de
in
temps.
In order to save time, what is the best way forward?
Quelle est la meilleure façon d'économiser notre temps précieux?
Of course, there will be certain requirements of the times to move forward. However, I believe in the trial chamber, with their discretion to find ways in order to save time.
La chambre de première instance a bien sûr la possibilité
so in order
de prendre
to ensure
des décisions
that we
pour améliorer
time,
la, l'efficacité de la procédure et l'accélérer. Donc, afin d'économiser
what should be
le plus
the
de temps
important
possible,
contribution by the prosecution?
Quelle devrait être la contribution
first, we will
importante
on the evidence
de l'accusation?
Documents
bon, nous allons d'abord
proffered
nous pencher
by the prosecution.
Sur les documents présentés par les procureurs.
And if we refer to Rule 87.1, parties may submit documents.
Et selon la règle 87.1, les parties
all
peuvent
evidence
produire
is admissible
des documents
unless it is provided otherwise in this IR.
Sauf disposition contraire.
And other subsequent sub-rules in Rule 87. So if all document is admissible, then I believe that
donc, si la preuve est libre,
all the evidence will be voluminous. So in order to make sure that all of those documents are relevant to the case, particularly to implicate the accused, and it is the onus of the onus is on the co-prosecutor to prove
et
the guilt of the accused. So the
prosecutors
should prove and establish
les
the standard of proof in order to ensure that those evidence are admissible and they have to link it with the criminal intent of the accused, for example, that
lier,
those documents is necessary. So if by admitting all the documents, I believe that certain documents are irrelevant, other documents might be not reliable, and certain documents are not authenticated at all, if they are not original, sometimes they take a statement that cannot be taken into consideration. So if we simply admit every document submitted by the prosecution, I believe that is the source of the waste of time. So in order to determine the credible evidence that to be submitted before the chambers, we suggest that the prosecution will have to be mindful of that.
La chambre doit considérer C'est une question que les procureurs doivent garder à l'esprit.
I would like to bring to your attention an extract of the jurisprudence of the third trial chamber of the ICTY.
La jurisprudence provenant de la chambre de première instance du TPY.
In case of Pralik. Pralik.
Pralik.
P-O-L-I-C.
Polic.
In this excerpt, I would like to read out in English.
J'aimerais lire en anglais.
Because it is an excerpt, so I want to read it out verbatim.
J'aimerais donc vous en lire l'intégralité pour éviter des problèmes de traduction.
4,000 documents without prior discussion over them in court may unduly delay the proceeding.
Cela peut retarder indûment la procédure.
To extend that, the chamber would not have the benefit of explanation
si la chambre
from a witness who would help to put these documents in their context
qui permettrait de mettre ces documents dans
and establish their relevance and probability probative value.
Et leur valeur probante.
The chamber would therefore be required
en l'absence donc
to spend much of its resources examine and accessing thousands of documents.
Des ressources considérables pour avoir
we could take several months
milliers de documents, ce qui pourrait prendre
and would delay
plusieurs mois.
The pronouncement of judgment.
Retarderait
the Lacani du jugement.
This court also concludes that, and I would like to once again read it out in English.
Et donc, therefore, la chambre en arrive à la conclusion suivante.
Has the duty to make
la
a choice
donc l'obligation de faire le choix
and identify those documents which are strictly necessary
les documents qui sont strictement nécessaires
for the determination of point in issue and present those documents
la question
to a witness who is able to provide
ces documents à un témoin
the chamber information in court about authenticity, relevance, and probative value
de sa valeur
of such.
Thank you. So based on this jurisprudence,
et donc,
the prosecutor has the responsibility
selon
to prove the relevance of the documents to be put before the chamber. And if they simply supply the document as provided for in internal rule 87.1, I believe that the document will be voluminous and,
le simple fait de déposer
and
le document,
in order
selon
to determine the specific document that is relevant, I think that it requires a lot of time. So in order to avoid time wasting, I think that the prosecution the inculpatory evidence proffered by the prosecution shall be specific and shall be proved with the established standards.
So, dans le respect des normes établies.
So long as there is a reliable evidence, we would be able to debate based on the basis
si
of reliable evidence, and there is it is not meant that the defense intends to delay
sur
the proceeding.
Point de départ, il n'est pas vrai que la défense cherche à retarder la procédure.
Coca.
Relating to the establishment of the general principle on the admissibility of evidence, how do we establish the principle?
Comment le principe général quant à la recevabilité des éléments?
I listened attentively to Mr. Michael Canavas. He pointed to three important points. One on the authenticity, second on the reliability of the evidence, and the third one on the relevance of the evidence. These are the three principles which the criteria for the chamber to listen to the oral arguments on these three principles. And as the defense, we do not deny the fact that certain evidence submitted by the prosecutor are admissible or useful to ascertaining the truth in the case. However, there must be an examination. A thorough examination on the reliability, its authenticity, and its relevance as well to the present case at hand. We cannot assume that evidence submitted is admissible. In addition, the observation by the chamber which may in any way amount to the presumption of admission of the evidence, particularly the documents in the footnotes of the closing orders are admissible. On this particular point, I think that this may be a cause of misleading as well. As to how much do we determine that those evidence are admissible? They are admissible for certain information contained in the footnotes of the closing order.
Je pense ici aux certains renseignements dans les notes de bas de page de la décision de renvoi.
When the co-investigating judges issued a closing order, they had footnotes in the closing order in support of the statement or arguments or decision of the co-investigating judges themselves. And it is the summary determination, for example, the co-investigating judges simply pointed to certain documents or titles of the documentary evidence or books or so. So it is a mere summary of the text. It is not the overall content in those texts or books or evidence. So what poses a question here is that the content in each document may not be consistent or may not corroborate one another. So it is important that the chamber consider that, because in one text there might be some contradiction or there might be certain areas which remain questionable. So my question is, if we simply admit those documents as acceptable by the chamber,
si la chambre juge cela acceptable,
how reliable it is, because in one particular document there might be certain areas which are contradictory as well. So I think it is important that we have to debate or examine those evidence before the court so that they become officially admissible. We have to make sure that those documents are the original documents that has been proved by the author themselves. And we know that documents were produced by human beings, so there must be a source that we can track. And of course, if it is made by human beings are subject to making errors as well, so it should be subject to examination. I would also like to once again stress on the onus of proof of the prosecution.
Que le fardeau de la preuve incombe
if he assumes that all evidence is admissible before this
si
court without any examination,
tous les éléments de preuve sont recevables sans les étudier.
I think this seriously prejudices.
Il s'agirait d'une situation.
The mission to find the truth.
Fortement préjudiciable.
Why? Because by examining evidence,
we cannot de la
be sure that all of those evidence constitute the real evidence that reflects the truth. So examination is
éléments de preuve, soit le
indispensable because parties will have the opportunity to
whether
object against what is in those evidence or they accept that and they will be able to provide supporting arguments.
Et fournir des arguments à l'appui de leur dépôt.
And once again, the documents are, for example, authentic or so, it does not necessarily mean that it can be always admissible.
Et un document peut être
so I think that by putting those documents before the chamber, it's easier for the chamber to hear the argument by all parties.
And if,
if one party believes that those evidence are reliable evidence, but the other party thinks otherwise, so the decision will lie upon the decision of the chamber. And again, on this same sub-rule, 87.1,
toujours sur cette règle, 87.1,
if the onus is on the defense for the evidence submitted by the prosecution, it seems that there is a shift in the responsibility
si la
to prove the reliability of the evidence beyond reasonable doubt, and that should be the onus of proof of the prosecution.
Que ce serait la défense de
however, once the prosecutor submits certain documents, and if the responsibility falls on the defense,
si c'est à la défense que revient cette
regarding our objection, and there is a requirement that we have to prove, for example, the authenticity or relevance of such documents, so that onus of proof will be shifted to the defense rather
donc
than
de reversement
the prosecution.
De la charge de preuve, si l'on interprétait la règle de cette façon.
So, it seems to me that the prosecutors knows for sure that the onus of proof is on the prosecution, but when it comes to whether or not we want to indicate the probative values or the relevance or authenticity of the document, the defense who wishes to challenge those documents will have to approve them. But that is not a correct assumption, because once the prosecutor has the onus of proof, then all the documents submitted by the prosecutor, they have to prove its relevance, its reliability.
Doivent être authentifiés et prouvés comme fiables par l'accusation.
Because there is one overall principle which requires that the prosecutor
un principe prévaut
proof the evidence before, beyond reasonable doubt, because there is one universal principle which the accused are presumed innocent unless proof guilty otherwise by the court. So now the accused is being presumed innocent
est donc
because there has not been any final decision rendered against the accused. So if he is presumed innocent, then the prosecutor will have to prove his guilt beyond reasonable doubt.
That is the overall principle
which gives the responsibility to the prosecutor. It does not necessarily mean that the prosecutors merely present an evidence and they do not have to elaborate on the substance of the evidence. They have to prove the authenticity, the reliability, and the relevance of those evidence in order to prove the guilt of the accused. So to recap what I have presented,
pour résumer,
Rule 87.1,
la règle 87.1 du règlement intérieur,
the admissibility of evidence does not mean that those evidence are submitted or are accepted by the chamber. The evidence
ne signifie pas que
that are considered admitted must undergo examination by all parties in order to ensure its authenticity, its relevance, and its reliability in this case. As the defense for my client, I reaffirm my position that we would object to any evidence.
Dans le cadre de la défense de mon client, je répète que nous nous opposons à tout élément de preuve
examination
qui n'est pas suivi
and any presumption of admissibility is not correct in any proceedings.
Il est fautif de présumer la recevabilité d'un élément de preuve.
Finally, we would like to urge the trial chamber
finalement, nous
not to admit
demandons à la chambre de première instance
any piece of evidence
de ne pas
that is not placed before the chamber for examination because
recevable tout élément de preuve qui n'a pas été déposé à l'audience
might not be authentic or might not be reliable or relevant
non
in this case.
Non fiable ou non pertinent.
So the trial chamber should not consider those evidence for the basis of its decision. Thank you.
Ne devrait pas s'appuyer sur ces éléments de preuve pour cette
the
décision.
Thank you, Defense Counsel, for your general observation on this. And I think that the defense has been repetitious in terms of the chamber's decision to admit
the evidence. Rendu par la
I think that the defense might overlook
the
sub-rule 87.1 point 2 of the rules of evidence. So the chamber would like to read out rule 87.2 for you. Internal rule 87.2 provides that any decision of the chamber shall be based only on evidence that has been put before the chamber and subjected to examination. So the Rule 87.2, which you may have overlooked,
apparemment la défense a omis de prendre en considération
likely,
cette règle.
To clarify your concerns,
que cette règle vient elle-même répondre
the decision
aux
to,
questions soulevées par la défense.
Admit evidence.
Pour ce qui est en particulier des décisions relatives à l'admission des éléments de preuve.
There was one issue this morning. The defense for Kilsom Porn requested that Kilsom Porn be granted an opportunity to make an oral submission to the chamber in relation to his right to remain silent or his right to respond to certain arguments in court.
De répondre à certains arguments qui ont été avancés.
And regarding this issue, the chamber asked Mr. Kilsompon last week, and Mr. Kilsompon said he would reserve his time to consult with his lawyer first. So I think if we leave this issue, then we may have forgotten it, or it may impact on the schedule of the chamber.
Si nous laissons cette question de côté, cela pourrait avoir des incidences sur le calendrier des audiences.
So the security guards are now instructed to bring Mr. Kilsompon to the dock so that he can ascertain his position whether or not he wants to exercise his right to remain silent or he wants to make any submission for himself. Counsel. Thank you, Mr. President. I would like to put it on record. And it should be clear on the record as well of what I quoted from the jurisprudence of International Tribunal. The title of that
jurisprudence is Decision on Admission of Evidence. Decision on Admission of Evidence.
Handed down by chamber, Trial Chamber 3.
Handed down by Trial Chamber 3. La décision rendue par la Chambre de l'instance numéro 3. En date
of July
2006, juillet 2006,
page 6 and page 7.
6 et 7.
Thank you.
Merci.
The President, Mr. Kilsompon, late last
week,
the international co-prosecutor requested the chamber that you be asked as to whether you maintain your position to remain silent,
poser la question de savoir si vous gardez
or you
votre position consistant
wish
à garder
to exercise
le silence,
your right to respond
si
to the questions,
de réponse aux questions qui vous sont posées,
asked by the chamber and parties.
Par la chambre et par les parties.
And the question were relevant to the facts in trial segment 2 in relation
avec
to
les faits
the
du deuxième segment.
Structure, administrative structure of the Democratic Cambodia.
Administrative du Cambodia démocratique.
So, what is your opposition after your consultation with your defense counsel?
Vos avocats. Je vous demande quelle est votre position.
Mr. Kilsompon, Mr. President,
Monsieur le Président,
Your Honours,
Madame, Messieurs les Juges,
everyone in an account in around the courtroom,
je salue venerable toutes les monks, personnes présentes dans le prétoire et dans la galerie du public. Je salue les vénérables moines
and beloved compatriots.
Je salue mes compatriotes bien-aimés.
I thank you, Mr. President, for granting me the opportunity to speak.
De m'avoir donné l'occasion de prendre la
parole.
I would
like to add to my position I demonstrated on Thursday last week. I observe
la position
that
telle que je l'ai indiquée jeudi dernier.
There are individuals who still do not understand my position,
que certains
continuent
and
de they
ne
raise
pas comprendre
questions.
Ma position et de poser certaines questions à ce sujet.
And they do not understand my position regarding the
Ces
question asked by the chamber
pas
and the parties.
Concernant les questions qui
In the
sont
hearing
posées
on the 13th of December,
lors de l'audience du 13 décembre,
I stated expressly my position,
indiqué expressément
and
quelle
I
était ma position.
I am of the opinion that my position remains that
Ma position
clear.
However,
me semble clair.
I see the necessity to clarify it again in order to avoid any confusion or misunderstanding.
Pour éviter toute confusion et tout malentendu.
I said it clearly, and I would like to repeat now
je vais répéter
that
ce
I
que
have
j'ai
a
déjà
request
dit clairement.
To participate actively
à savoir que je souhaite participer
in my case.
Activement à l'examen de mon affaire.
However, I won't forget
toutefois,
that this is my trial, and the prosecutor claims that I have committed
il s'agit
notorious
de mon procès.
Crimes,
l'accusation
and I categorically reject it.
Des grives, des
it is
graves,
the prosecutor
que je rejette
who have
catégoriquement.
To prove the
c'est
evidence.
À l'accusation qu'il appartient
to support their
de
prosecution against me,
ces allégations.
So
et de
that I can defend myself appropriately.
À l'appui. Quant à moi, je pourrais
therefore, I will have to wait until
appropriée.
When I am presented with
je
the evidence.
Je vais attendre qu'on me présente des preuves.
So that I can examine it.
Ce n'est qu'à ce moment-là que je
before
pourrai
I
examiner
can
ces
respond to all the
pour
questions.
Ensuite répondre à toutes les questions qui pourraient m'être posées.
And I would like to earnestly request the chamber that I be given the opportunity to comment.
Je prie la chambre de me donner l'occasion
express my opinions on the
faire
facts.
Valoir mon avis au sujet des faits.
Raised in the various paragraphs in the closing order which the trial chamber will read out or indicate in the coming hearings as the chamber has granted me such opportunity so far, particularly on the 13th of December. In response, I will eventually respond to every question concerning the facts raised by parties,
de répondre à toutes les questions que me poseraient les
and
parties
I would
concernant
answer
les faits.
Questions regarding the documents as well. But once again, it must, I would respond
mais je le répète,
until and unless those documents has
je ne
been
répondrai pas
fully provided.
Tant que les documents pertinents ne m'auront pas été
for example,
présentés.
When there was a
je prends un exemple.
Oral argument relating to the historical background of the Communist Party Cambodia, it was almost coming to a conclusion already, but there was no not sufficient document presented to me, and there was no any mentioning that those documents will be raised again in the subsequent hearings.
Et on n'a pas non plus dit que l'on reviendrait sur ces
and
documents
witnesses
lors des audiences ultérieures.
And expert witnesses who will appear to testify
des
before this court
et des témoins experts
will be
vont être
questioned
entendus par la chambre.
In the relating to the historical
et
background of the Democratic Cambodia
sur le
or not.
Contexte historique ou sur d'autres questions.
In my understanding now, more documents will be provided on subsequent occasions.
De nouveaux documents vont probablement être présentés ultérieurement.
And those documents will be subject to
et ces documents
oral examination and cross-examination.
D'un débat contradictoire.
Why would I wish if I am authorized to
apporter d'éventuels commentaires
to make
sur les paragraphes
possible
de l'ordonnance de clôture
on paragraphs
au fur et à mesure du procès.
As the trial goes
mais
on.
Je ne répondrai pas aux questions
I,
de quelque sorte que ce soit
hand, will not answer any kind
avant
of
la fin de la présentation de l'ensemble des éléments de preuve, autrement dit, à l'issue du procès.
Words,
I strongly hope that each and everyone in this courtroom understand my position.
Comprennent ma position.
I thank you, Mr. President,
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président,
your honors, member
Madame,
of the bench,
juges,
for your attention.
De votre attention.
Thank you. The President.
Le Président.
Thank you, Mr. Kyusampon, for
Monsieur
reiterating your position
d'avoir réitéré votre
and participating
position
in the hearings,
et d'avoir ainsi
particularly
pris part
hearings on the facts relating to your case in case file
002/1.
This will be, of course, transcribed in the transcription, and parties will take your position into consideration. It is now appropriate for an adjournment for lunch. So we will break for lunch, and we will resume at 1:30.
L'audience reprendra à 13h30.
Counsel, you may now proceed.
Thank you, Your Honor. Thank you. If I may, just a brief word on Nunchia's presence. We are informed that Nunchia would like to waive his right to be present, to participate in the proceedings, meaning that he would like to return to the detention center for the duration of the week. We are informed also that he's still in the holding cell. He did make that request earlier this morning, so we would like to reiterate it now. He would like to remain in the detention center for the rest of the week, waiving his right to participate.
Durant toute la semaine, thank you. En renonçant à son droit de participer à l'audience.
Yes, the prosecutor, you may now proceed.
Le président, la parole est au
procureur. Your Honor, the prosecution, I think, has made their position clear, and I think so has the trial chamber.
Les procureurs ont indiqué clairement leur position, la chambre aussi, à savoir que l'accusé est obligé d'être présent à son procès, soit dans le prétoire, soit dans la cellule de détention provisoire.
We would ask that this application be rejected.
Nous demandons que la requête présentée par l'accusé soit rejetée.
The President.
Le Président.
The accused Nunchia, through his defense counsel, decides to waive his right to participate in the hearing, both in the courtroom as well as in the holding cell, where audiovisual connection is prepared for him, and he requests that he be transferred to his detention facility. The chamber rejects this request, and the chamber also upholds the ruling of the chamber made this morning. The
la décision qu'elle accused a rendue
Saul
ce matin,
remained in the holding cell,
à savoir que l'accusé
the
restera
audio-visual
dans la
equipment
salle,
was,
dans la cellule
prepared
de détention
for him so that he can follow the
dans laquelle
proceedings
a été installé
by
du matériel audiovisuel
means,
permettant à l'accusé de suivre
already ordered
l'audience.
The technician
la chambre
to
a déjà
connect
demandé
the audio-video link for him so that he can participate in this proceeding for the rest of the week by remote means.
Jusqu'à la fin
so
de la semaine
the
et
security
à distance.
Guard
à présent,
does not do not have to bring the two accused
les agents de sécurité
to the courtroom. They may remain in the holding cell. And you simply report the situation to the greffier.
Priez.
So security guards are now instructed to bring Mr. Khieu Somphone to the holding cell and bring him back to this courtroom before 1:30.
Dans la cellule provisoire et de le ramener à 13h30.